perfect the moves or the Akidoka Chiwaza or the standing techniques? How do they differ from what we just witnessed?
Well, in this case, both people are standing, as we would be in daily life, normal daily life.
And are the techniques the same?
Depends which ones they demonstrate. I think that someone tried to count the number of techniques that the founder taught, and they gave up after 3,500. They stopped counting. So. So what he's demonstrating here is a very basic technique of, you can see by the time you turn, you're both people's energies going in the same direction. It's fundamental beginning to countless techniques. And we use it at the beginning of class.
And Aikido, roughly translated into the way of unifying life energy?
Yes. And this particular exercise is about something called musubi, meaning to blend, to bring together, to blend.
And what is being, what are they blending?
We're blending the physical energy, spiritual energy, you know, like we talk about energy ki, and physical form. You can see by the time the person doing it has turned, they're virtually mirror image, back to back or hand to hand, whatever it is.
How does Aikido evolve?
You mean as an overall art or within the individual?
Both, I guess.
Well, as an art form, it's evolved because as different people take it up and then spend a lifetime training, it's not uncommon for people to train 40, 50, 60 years nowadays. And we're seeing a different development. Also, cultural developments in each country make it different. The differences between men and women, the differences between large people and smaller people. People who have a Buddha background, maybe from very strong combat art, or people who have no background or real interest in anything related to combat. Many people like me came from other martial arts. I did judo and karate as well when I was a young man. So that's the evolution. I think it's a bit like my teacher, my master used to say, it's like cultivating a human being. So if you put seeds in a garden, one will come up to be an oak tree, one will come up to be a flower. You don't know when they come up what they're going to be, but the idea is for them to evolve into what they are. But the physical side of Aikido is still that you have to work very hard. You must work hard. And you have to train in a situation where your techniques have to work.
Now, when developing new techniques, is that accepted? If some of these younger Aikidokas working in the dojo and they feel that, you know, they found something that works maybe better than another technique, is it possible to implement that into the art?
Yes.
And what does it need to, what needs to happen for it to be accepted universally?
It's automatically accepted. But when it comes to basics, which are the vehicle for teaching, they remain the same. There are different ways of applying them and teaching them. Every teacher is different, but the basic forms remain the same. And this is a very good example. You've got people from all around the world doing things which are essentially exactly the same. Like rap all over the world would be rap. If it changes, it, you know, becomes a cappella or something is different.
I see. And what does the future hold, do you believe, for Aikido around the world?
I think basically growth. It's hard to say. I don't know. I mean, I've had my time now. I'm getting older now, and I'm starting to realize it'll go on long beyond me. I mean, these two men demonstrating that, I've known both of those since they were babies. One of them, the one Jiko with the grey hair, he was the son of my teacher. So I've known him for, you know, I've known him for all of his 47 years.
Are you allowed to announce how old he is?
47.
For viewers that have never been exposed to this type of art, what they would see, the optics, is everything is very circular.
Well, at this point, yes, they see that, and they're probably wondering, well, why is it all so smooth? Why is everyone responding so positively? That would be the normal reaction. You know, why isn't someone trying to surprise someone else. But what we're trying to do is to get to a point where you can move in complete harmony with whatever happens. And later on you'll see much more, if you like, adventurous physical movement, much more dynamic. But at this point, these are basics.
Also through my studies, I learned about this very important balance, movement, calmness, flexibility, and the ability to cover vulnerable areas.
All of that, yes.
Is there specific emphasis on any one of those, or is it everything in harmony?
Fundamental is that if you consider that Aikido came from training against a weapon, you couldn't block a sword, for example. You can't block a spear if it's thrust in. You can redirect it, but it'll come in another direction. It'll be withdrawn, thrust again. So Aikido is based on the idea of it doesn't have blocks in the sense we think of blocking normally, for example. It has redirections. And again, he's doing this in a very measured, controlled way, so you can see what's happening.
Is there any type of specific training to ensure that you're strong? Obviously, we're seeing
resistance. Yeah. Normally, this light training. I mean, the world I grew up in. One of the things you notice about Aikido people is they'll have hairy wrists and hair, because people hang on so hard they never had like Chinese burn. So you big monsters, they hang on to you hard. So one form of training, not what you're seeing here, is very static. People really holding you and you have to move.
A beautiful display of martial arts abilities. And you can just see the beauty in it. Can understand, especially for many of us who have never been witnessed, who have never had a chance to witness this art, why so many people love it.
Well, this next demonstration would promise to be quite fast, in contrast to that.
Team, we move now to the second part of these demonstrations with freestyle and weapons and Randori, which is defending against multiple attackers. Russia is our first team to demonstrate.
Вторую часть показательных выступлений, в котором будем показывать свободные техники. Техники с оружием и техники против магии.